Hello my gems, this is Shelly and in today's video I'm going to review the Korean skincare brand Pyeonggang-yul. And this brand is something that I checked out back in 2017. I first used their toner and a shampoo and I loved those products, so I went ahead and tried out so many products from the brand. I used most of these products back in 2018 and 19, and all the products that I'm going to mention in today's video are empty and fully used up. And I mainly wanted to put up this video in 2020, but by the time I decided to put up this video on my channel, then lockdown happened and many Korean websites like this stopped shipping to India. In fact, these websites are not yet shipping to India. So I was like, there is no point in putting up this video as many of you will not be able to import the products. So I kept on pushing back this video, but from past couple of months I have been seeing that some of the Indian K-beauty website have started carrying this brand, and I was like, I have to do the video now because some of you might be looking up for the review, so it's the right time. And also to ease up things for you, I'm gonna link all these K-beauty Indian website where you can get this Pyeonggang-yul brand in the description box below. So do check out the description box below to look out for those website. So most of the Pyeonggang-yul products are like essential oil free, fragrance free and have very simple formulation. So if you are somebody who is always in a lookout for a very sensitive skin friendly products, or if you have like rosacea prone skin, or if you deal on and off with a bad skin barrier issue, then this brand is something that you absolutely need to check out. So in today's video I will be reviewing their toners, serum, moisturizer, few of the body care product, and in the end I will let you know my two must-have products from the brand Pyeonggang-yul. So at first I have the Pyeonggang-yul mist toner. This is a very watery, extremely lightweight, non-sticky toner, and you can get it in two different sizes. Like this is a bigger bottle. It is available in 200 ml quantity as well as in 100 ml quantity, and I have used up three bottles of this. Like two I have with me in this video, and one you can find in a very old video of 2017. And this toner works by reducing your skin temperature. In case like if you get heated up skin, you have general redness issue or irritation issue, or especially like if you're dealing with rosacea, this toner is something you should definitely check out for the summer season. Highly, highly recommend it. And the next toner is the Pyeonggang-yul Essence Toner, and this is like one of their very famous product, and again it is available in 200 ml size and 100 ml size, and with me I have the 100 ml bottle. Like this size and shape doesn't look like as if it is 100 ml, but this is a 100 ml bottle. And compared to this mist toner, this has a slightly more viscous, bouncy texture, and it is more on a hydration side. Since this is the essence toner, you can use it at the toner step and also at the essence step. Since this was a very famous toner back in 2017 and 18, I had a lot of expectation from this, but I didn't like it that much. I overall found it okay. Like many people claim like they found it very hydrating. I honestly didn't find it that hydrating on my skin. So since I had it, I was just using it here and there, and I somehow used it up fully. Like this toner can be used by all skin type, but if you have skin type which is like normal, dry and combination, this will be best suited for the summer time and also for the monsoon time. But if you have like oily to very oily skin, this is going to be a good option for the winter time. Next I will be reviewing two serums that I have from the brand Pyeonggang-yul, and at first I have the Pyeonggang-yul moisture serum. This serum bottle comes in a huge 100 ml quantity. Like you will not find many serum in this huge size, and this has a very lightweight, milky lotion like consistency, and when you apply it on your skin, it first changes to a watery consistency and then gets absorbed into your skin. When I was using this serum in full swing on daily basis for both morning and night routine, I saw that it made my skin soft, overall healthy, and also added that healthy healthy glow on my skin. Like, this serum basically works by improving the blood circulation on your face, and better the blood circulation on your face, it gives the glowy skin. So this is how this serum works, and this is why I feel that if you have in general very dry and dull skin for no reason, this is something you should definitely check out for yourself. And because of the consistency and the ingredient it has, I feel that if you have like normal dry and combination skin, we all can use it for all season, but if you have like oily to very oily skin, this is going to be a good option for the winter season. And the next product is the Pyongyang Yun Moisture Ampoule, and these two bottles honestly look very similar at first glance, and it can confuse many of you, but these two serums are entirely two different species. Like, they have different skin function, they have entirely different texture, and this ampoule has a very unique texture. Like, it comes out in a very viscous, very sticky gel sort of texture. So when you apply it on your skin, don't rub it, instead pat it on your skin and let the ampoule sink into your skin properly before you apply anything else on your face. So once you have like patted this ampoule onto your skin, you will immediately feel that this ampoule, just like this mist toner that I reviewed in the beginning, this also works on your skin by reducing your skin temperature. So again, like, if you have issue of general redness, general irritation, or if your skin temperature rises up for no reason and you need something to calm down your skin, this is the product for you. And when I was using this ampoule consistently for both morning and night routine and on a daily basis, I noticed that it of course kept my skin calm and in good condition, but additionally, like, what surprised me, that this also kept my skin firm, and somehow it made my pores appear smaller. For the skin suitability, I feel that if you have like normal dry and combination skin, this is going to be a perfect product for the summer and monsoon season. But if you have like oily skin, this is going to be a fantastic option for all year around. And especially like if you have rosacea prone skin, I highly recommend this. You will see a good difference in your skin. Next, I will be reviewing 5 moisturizer from Pyongyang Yun. Like, strictly speaking, they are not the moisturizer, but they do fall into the category of moisturizer, so I have clubbed them together, and you will understand why I did this as I review these products one by one. First, I have the Pyongyang Yun Nutrition Cream, and this cream has a very rich, very moisturizing texture, so this is why I feel that it is the best option only for the dry skin people. And as I kept on using this moisturizer, it confused my skin. Sometimes what happened is, like, in spite of being so rich, it felt moisturizing on the surface and sometimes even sticky on the surface, but at the same time my skin felt dry on the inside. It seemed as if this moisturizer is either not sinking into my skin or it might be dehydrating my skin. So something went wrong by the time I finished half of the tub. So this is why I found it overall okay. This didn't wow me that much. The next moisturizer is the Pyongyang Yun Intensive Repair Cream. And you all know how much I love a good barrier moisturizer. I love checking them out. So this moisturizer has all the skin barrier friendly ingredients. Like, it contains fatty acid from the macadamia seed oil, shea butter, and also has ceramide and copper peptide in it. So a really good ingredient list it has. And again, because of the formulation and everything, it has a very rich, very moisturizing texture. If I consistently use this moisturizer, it broke me out. Like, if I used it sometime here and there, it was working, but even if for a week I used it consistently, it broke me out. So this is why I really couldn't use it much on my face. I instead finished this off by using as a hand moisturizer. And the third product in this category is the Pyongyang Yun Balancing Gel. Like, this product has a very unique and weird texture. Like, it comes in a very viscous, very stiff, very sticky gel sort of consistency. Like, this moisture ampoule and this balancing gel, they more or less have similar texture, but the moisture ampoule is way lighter than this balancing gel. So this is like very sticky, almost like very concentrated, very sticky honey. So it is like way more stickier than the honey. So now you can understand how sticky this must be. So because of the texture, do not rub this product onto your skin. Instead, take out the needed quantity, apply it on your face and pat it and press it into your skin so that the product sinks in and settles well on your skin. And even on my dry skin, like after 5 minutes of application, it still felt sticky, and it took almost 15-20 minutes for the stickiness to go up. It can be used for both morning and night, but only because of the texture, this product is best suited for the night time only, because in the morning I don't think many have time and patience to work this kind of product onto your skin. So this is why this is considered as a sleeping mask, and you use it after using your toner, essence, serum, moisturizer, and towards the end apply this onto your face. When I was using this, I definitely liked the result which it gave on my face. Like whenever I used it at night, next morning I always woke up to a very healthy, bright and a very soft skin. So my skin overall looked very good next morning. Even though this product works so well on my skin, I still was not reaching out for it that often because of the texture. Like I don't have the patience to work on this kind of texture. So I hope that they change the packaging of this product from a jar kind to a tube kind, because it will be easy. Like with the tube kind of packaging, you can directly apply this product on your face and work it on. So next I have the eye cream from Pyongyangyul. Like currently they have two eye creams. One is in the black packaging, and I have their eye cream which they launched first in 2018 or 19. I really don't remember. So anyways, this is the eye cream, like one of the eye creams from Pyongyangyul. And this comes in a 50 ml quantity, and it contains individual 50 packs, with each having a quantity of 1 ml. Every time I took out that one pack, I had to use it for all over face, because that 1 ml quantity is a lot for your eye area. You hardly need 1/4 of the 1 ml quantity for your eye area alone. So I ended up using it on my face, eye area and even neck. And so this is why I added this to a moisturizer category, because I was basically using it as a moisturizer. And when I was using it, I definitely noticed an overall improvement in my skin condition. It made my skin look healthy and bright. And it contains very simple formulation for an eye cream. Like it mainly contains shea butter. It also contains fermented ginseng extract and licorice root extract. And all of these ingredients, they help in repairing your skin. They also add glow on your skin. So formulation wise, performance wise, all good, but I still did not like it much because of the packaging. I do get the idea why they went for this individual pack packaging. Maybe because to avoid using any harsh preservative in the formulation, and secondly to keep the product fresh and more effective for every single usage. So I get that idea, but again, that did not make this product very feasible and very practical for the daily usage. Like every time I had to take out a pouch, use a scissor to cut the pack, because it cannot be, at least I couldn't like tear it apart with my hands. I needed a scissor for every usage. So, and also additionally, it generates a lot of wastage. So I'm really not happy with the packaging. Maybe they can change it to a tube kind of packaging. So the next moisturizer is the Pyongyangyul Aatu Cream, and I have a very old version of it. This was the first version that was launched in the year, I guess, 2017 or 18. So a really old version. And after that, they have repackaged it so many times. And I'm sure they must have reformulated to some extent. So reviewing this Aatu cream is not going to be that useful. So I'm just casually going to share my experience with this. So this moisturizer, like this Aatu cream and their entire Aatu range, is made for the people who have sensitive and damaged skin. I really did not like this cream that much. It was okay for me. Sometime it felt sticky, while other time it didn't feel moisturizing enough. And also if I continuously used it for 2 weeks or something, it also gave me whiteheads. And next, for the hair and body care line, I first have this Pyongyangyul Aatu Cleanser Blue Label. This cleanser, like the one which I have, is also an older version. Latest version has some different labeling. It's made for the people who have sensitive skin, even on body. and because of a very gentle formulation, this can be used on face as well, but I was not comfortable using it on face. I was mainly using it as a body cleanser and I liked it. And next I have the shampoo from the Pyongyangul, and this used to be like one of my favorite shampoo, and I have used up I guess 3 or 4 bottles of it. But every time, I think after the second purchase, I bought the product or checked out the product on website, I saw that they have changed the packaging, they have changed the labeling, or they have even changed the formulation. So the last time when I bought this shampoo, I was really not happy how the shampoo worked on my hair and scalp. I found it a bit drying, but previously I really loved this shampoo because it was super gentle on my hair and also on my scalp. But the formulation which I used last time was not good enough. I don't know why they keep on changing the formulation and labeling. Like, please make up your mind, it's very confusing. So again, I'm mentioning this shampoo just to let you know that Pyongyangul does have hair care line as well, and you can check it out. Like, it is not available in India at the moment, but if you happen to live outside India, you can get it from stylekorean.com, and I think even YesStyle carries it. At number 2, I have the Pyongyangul Moisture Ampoule, and at number 1, I have the Pyongyangul Mist Toner. These two products are unique, and even till date, I have not found an alternative to these. This is why I decided to mention them in my top 2 products list from the brand Pyongyangul. So if you have like sensitivity issue, rosacea issue, definitely check these two out, and I'm sure you will not be disappointed. Overall, I do like Pyongyangul as a brand, and they did launch so many new products last year, and I really wanted to try them out, but because of the lockdown, I couldn't get my hands on it. Because since I have like dry sensitive and acne prone skin, I prefer using very simple formulation products. So that's all for today's video, and if you have any other Korean skincare brand in your mind that you want me to review, you can leave your recommendation in the comment section below, and I will see you in my next upload. Bye.